Today I want to compare the 7X lens, the telephoto camera from the Mavic 3 to the 7X lens, the telephoto camera from the Mavic 3 Pro and see how much of a difference there is and maybe how much of an improvement there is in the latest drone from DJI. So let's go out and get some footage. First up, we're going to start with the Mavic 3 Cine, which is my main workhorse drone from last year until the Mavic 3 Pro was released. Next, we're gonna shoot with the Mavic 3 Pro Cine. Seems like a mouthful, but the aperture has changed from f4.4 to f3.4, so it gives you a little bit better low light performance. Mostly, I'm interested in seeing how much sharper, how much better the image quality is, but that is definitely gonna make a difference. So I've matched up ND filters as close as I can, but we'll see what we end up with. Now there are some differences between these two drones in the specs, and I will jump into those later as far as the frame rates you can shoot, the types of footage you can shoot, the f-stop and all that. But first, let's start looking at some of the footage. The first thing that stands out to me is the difference in colors. The Mavic 3 is quite a bit more muted than the Mavic 3 Pro. I had to pull the saturation back anywhere from 30 to 40% depending on the shot to get the same level of saturation. And I shot these as close to the same time periods as I possibly could to try and make sure there was no difference in lighting or anything like that. The differences don't seem that apparent until we start putting the shots side by side. And here you can start to see some difference. Now there's tons of detail in these shots, lots of little leaves, gravel, rocks, all kinds of things. But you can definitely start to see where the 3 Pro lens is a little bit better and a little bit sharper in most cases, even when I was shooting just the H.265 files, which is right here. But the big difference to me comes when I put my face side by side. Here there's a giant difference in how the lens focuses, and even though they are slightly different telephoto lengths, one's 162 and one's 166, the difference in the detail and the amount of focus on the Mavic 3 Pro compared to the Mavic 3 on a closed subject like that on my face is really substantial. I mean, yes, you can sharpen the Mavic 3 up to about 3.5% and get it closer, but the Mavic 3 Pro just definitely has a better, sharper overall image. I do think it's partly because of the new optics, but I also think it's maybe partly because DJI did a little work in the software and they're doing a little bit more sharpening in camera or in the drone before you get that off. And I wish they would give us the opportunity to turn that off or at least control the amount of it that we get. In almost all cases, the Mavic 3 Pro is a little bit better. Now, in most cases, when I'm doing landscape stuff and far off stuff, the difference is pretty negligible. You don't see a massive amount of difference. But when you start getting close up to stuff and you start getting that real close focus, that's when the Mavic 3 Pro definitely pulls quite a ways ahead and looks quite a bit better. Now, there are some other differences that you need to be aware of. For one, this has a fixed aperture of f4.4, and it can only record up to 4K 50 frames a second, which is weird because I could have sworn that it recorded 4K 60 at some point. But anyway, it can only record up to 4K 50 frames a second. Whereas the new Mavic 3 Pro has an f-stop of 3.4, which means you'll get a little bit better performance in low light, and it can record 4K up to 60 frames a second. So if you like filming in 60 frames a second, and then you're maybe slowing it down to half speed for a 30 frame second timeline or something like that, the Mavic 3 Pro definitely a little bit better. And one more difference is that since both of these are the Cine model, they will shoot in ProRes, but the Mavic 3 will only shoot in ProRes on the main camera. It will only shoot in H.264, H.265 on the telephoto camera, whereas the Mavic 3 Pro will shoot in ProRes on all three cameras, so it will also shoot in ProRes. But to mitigate this, I shot in H.265 in a couple of shots to make sure I wasn't gaining anything extra from ProRes, but most of the shots are in ProRes. In all of these tests, I matched exposure as best as I could. I also had the same ND filters, or in a lot of cases, no ND filters, just to make sure that I had the same everything as close as I could. I made sure the white balance was the same. And while I did shoot ProRes in some of the shots on the Mavic 3 Pro, I also shot in H.265 to make sure that these tests came out as accurate and as close to an apples to apples comparison as they possibly could. There you go, a pretty clear difference in some cases. The Mavic 3 Pro definitely has better optics, better sharpness, a little bit better clarity. It also has a more open f-stop, so it does a little better, I mean, just a minute better in low light, where the Mavic 3 is, I mean, obviously it was their first deal on a 162 millimeter lens. Where I think they both do well, the Mavic 3 Pro definitely pulls ahead. Next, you're gonna wanna watch this video right here to see how I set my Mavic 3 Pro up, all the settings. I'll walk you through everything. I'll see you over there. As always, if you have questions, ask me in the comments below or join my live stream, which happens most Wednesday nights at 4 p.m. Alaska time, 8 p.m. Eastern. I'll see you again soon in the next video. Cheers.